tell you, 52 miles per gallon into the future. Yes, what did I tell you? It works. Yes, 52 miles per gallon.
Doc, it's me.
It can't be. I just sent you into the future.
I know you just sent me to the future in a gas electric hybrid time machine, but I'm back from the future. Unbelievable. There's more, Doc. You gotta hear it. In the future, there's like a major gas shortage. I barely had enough to make the trip home.
Great Scott!
It's like they used it all up for something, and nobody's come up with any alternative energy solutions. Not to mention the pollution and the smell.
Hurry, we've got to get back to the lab while there's still time.
Jeez Louise!
This is part of our latest experiment. This is the fry machine. This makes biodiesel travel possible.
Doc, are you telling me that you and your students built a device that can make fuel out of recycled French fry grease? And you put it in a school bus?
Precisely.
Great, Doc. So what do we do now? Like, travel back in time and warn people that they have to start growing more potatoes?
No. We're going back to the fry later.
Holy moly!
Come on, I'll show you how it works. All right, so this is your used oil. After you eat those fries, you got plenty of used oil. We pick it up, bring it over here, we heat it up, add a little methanol and potassium hydroxide, also known as potassium methoxylate. Put it together, put it into our processor, turn it on, heat it for an hour up to 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Not 150, 140 degrees Fahrenheit. Keep it going for an hour. Turn it off, sit it overnight, let it settle. Next day, what happens? All right, separates into the biodiesel and the glycerin. Right here, this biodiesel, that's what we're after. Glycerin's on the bottom, heavy stuff, looks great on the crops. We get that into our wash tank now. We turn on the water, sprinkles down through the biodiesel, taking out any extra glycerin, sinks it to the bottom. Next day, we take the biodiesel off, put it into our dry tank. Turn on the froggy, the blower, and he blows all the water out of the biodiesel. We end up with nice, clear biodiesel, ASTM certified.
What the heck is a pentium hydrogenated minoxidil mixture?
Allow me to demonstrate. I apologize for the crude of this model. I didn't have time to paint it or build it to scale.
No, it's great, Doc. The bus driver even kind of looks like you.
Once you've converted the fat to fuel, you simply fill the tank, and presto, off you go!
Wait a minute, Doc! What if all of a sudden people started eating healthier, leading to a huge shortage in fryolator grease? Wouldn't that cause a major paradox?
One revolution at a time! For now, let's fry!
This is heavy! Do we use, like, cheeseburger grease or something?
Oil? Where we're going, we don't need oil.
Yeah!